One in three adults here in the UK might develop diabetes in the future. So in this week's video, we're looking at diabetes. We're looking at why we need to keep our blood sugar levels down to remain healthy. We're going to look at what is a healthy blood sugar, and also we're going to look at how to lower that blood sugar level to keep you healthy. Now, before we begin, I just want to say, if anyone watching this video is planning on making some really big, drastic changes to try and bring their blood sugar levels down, please, please, please first speak to your healthcare professional and make them aware of this. This is the most important thing before we begin. Also, if you have diabetes, type 1 or type 2, if you're going to do any of these changes, make your healthcare professional aware of this, please. Now, I appreciate you all have busy lives, and this is going to be a relatively long video full of information. But if at any point you want to find any specific piece of information, please feel free to click on that description below. It's all chaptered. You can find the information that you require, go to it and watch it. However, I would always recommend that you watch the full video, because that way you're going to become a pro. Let's begin. So let's begin with blood sugar levels. You see, if you're diabetic or if you're pre-diabetic, it generally means that most of the time your blood sugar levels are quite high. This high blood sugar level can cause damage to your blood vessels. And this is especially apparent in those narrow blood vessels, such as to your eyes, to your kidneys, to your fingertips, to your toes. These are all quite narrow, and eventually over time, this high blood sugar level is going to cause damage to those blood vessels. And we see things that are quite common in diabetes. For example, you lose your eyesight, your kidneys deteriorate, you start to lose your feelings in your tips of your fingertips or on your toes. These are quite common. So as you can see, it's super important that your sugar levels remain stable, so relatively low within the normal range, because it can cause so much damage. Like your kidneys, like we said, over time they're going to deteriorate. And having diabetes, having these high blood sugar levels, can then increase your risk of things like heart attacks and strokes, and you really don't want that. So the question is, what kind of sugar levels are we looking for? What kind of blood glucose levels are we looking for? That's just a fancy word for the sugar levels in the blood. Well, we're looking for something between 4 to 7 millimoles at normal times, okay? This is before you've eaten. Please remember, these are the measurements that we use in the UK. In different countries, I know you use different measurements, so I will leave conversions in the description below. So 4 to 7 millimoles is considered normal. And after you've eaten, after 2 hours, if you then take your blood sugar levels with the strip and everything like that, it should be between 8.5 to 9 millimoles. So it should have dropped back down to that kind of range. However, please do remember, the readings that we expect for type 1 diabetics and type 2 diabetics are different, and I will leave more information and some useful links in the description below about this. Now, another really useful method for testing your blood sugar levels is checking something called your HbA1c. This is a blood test. We send the bloods to the lab and they calculate this. It's your HbA1c. You can't do it at home using a test strip and the finger pricker thing. That does not calculate that. So HbA1c, the way it works is it gives us a real average outlook of how your blood sugar levels have been over the past 3 months. And the reason I say over the past 3 months is it works by checking your red blood cells and how much sugar are stuck to them. Red blood cells generally have a lifespan of 3 months, so that's why I say 3 months. So it gives us an average indicator of how high or how low your blood sugars have been. And ideally, here in the UK, we want everyone's HbA1c to be below 42. That is the threshold. So anything below 42 is pretty good. Anything above 42 to 47 is what we call pre-diabetic. And anything above 47, we're then looking at diabetes diagnosis, but then you'll have to speak to your healthcare professional to go through all that with you. So that's just a brief overview of HbA1c. So now that we know the background, we know about the lab test, we know about the results, we know why we need to keep our blood sugar levels low, let's look at how you can keep those blood sugar levels low. As I said at the start of the video, I'm going to say it again. If you do plan on making any significant changes, please do speak to your healthcare professional first. Make them aware that you're doing this. And this is especially important if you're diabetic, whether you're type 1 or type 2, and you're taking medication for your diabetes. You really, really need to let them know that you're doing this, because otherwise your blood sugar levels might drop too low, and we definitely don't want that. Okay, so the first tip that I want to give you, it's pretty basic, but it's probably one of the most important things that you need to do, and it's all about what you eat. First of all, do not skip meals. Skipping meals is really, really bad, because what happens, you end up getting really, really hungry and you end up binging really quickly loads of food, and we get this massive sugar spike. What you want to do is have your set meals every single day, 3 meals a day, And also, you really want to pick foods that break down slowly. The slower that food breaks down, the longer it releases that energy in your body, and the lower that sugar spike is gonna be. It's gonna be more steady instead of a spike when you eat loads and loads of food. Now, the sort of foods that we eat need to be foods that are high in fiber, protein, or complex carbohydrates, and we're gonna go through these now. So initially, I was gonna list a few foods that are good for this, that are high in fibers, that are high in complex carbohydrates, that break down slowly, but I think the best way to do it is, hopefully it's already here, there's gonna be a box here with all the sort of foods that are good for this, that are gonna give us that slow release that we're looking for. That's the most important thing. We want that slow release and not that massive peak that we just spoke about. Now, the best high protein foods include things like fish, chicken, eggs, nuts, low-fat yogurts, low-fat cheeses. These things are good in proteins. What you really don't want to have is canned foods, ready meals, cured meats. These sort of things are not very high in these proteins, but also they're excessively high in salt. Now, whilst we're on the topic of salt, it's also important that you keep your blood pressure in check. I do have a few videos on this topic as well, which I will leave links to up here and in the description below. But in terms of salt, we're looking at a daily intake of 6 grams maximum, okay? So have a look at the foods that you're eating, look on the back of them, see how much of your total salt intake is in there. This is really important that you're also following this. Now, the next thing that I want to discuss is fats. It's usually something that we shy away from. We don't talk about it enough, but it's all about eating the right fats, and fats are important because certain vitamins are actually fat soluble, so we need the fats to be able to absorb them, such as vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E. So it's quite important that we're having the right fats. For example, avocados, nuts, seeds, oily fish, olive oil, all of these have good fats that are okay for us, obviously in moderation, but they're good for us. Now, to keep those sugar levels low, we also need to stay away from those processed foods, those sugary foods that are all processed, that are bad for us, that you end up snacking on. These are notoriously bad for keeping those sugar levels down, such as donuts, biscuits, cakes, all of these sort of things that also contain saturated fats or even trans fats, which are all notoriously bad for us, but they're also gonna increase our sugar levels. So we need to try and replace these, if you are having a lot of these kinds of snacks, with healthier options. So we can look at replacing these snacks that are unhealthy and that are bringing our sugar levels high with healthier options. For example, fruit, vegetables, chop them up into small pieces, have them there ready. So when you've got those cravings for a snack, you can quickly turn to that instead of that snack drawer. Keep that snack drawer away. Don't buy them, try not to buy them. Keep them somewhere that's difficult to reach, so it's not easy to access them whenever you want. These are the sort of things that you can do. I will leave more information on different snack ideas as well in the description below. And if you'd like to put sugar in your tea, in your coffee, whatever, try sweeteners instead, such as xylitol, for example. They don't have as much of an impact in increasing your sugar levels, your blood sugar levels, compared to normal sugar. So these can be quite useful as well to bear in mind. Now, moving on to the next topic for keeping those blood sugar levels down. Weight. How is your weight? If you're overweight, it's going to be a lot harder to keep those blood sugar levels down. You've got the visceral fat around your tummy. All of these can cause an increase in your blood sugar levels. So we need to look at losing weight if you are overweight. A really good, quick way to check if you are overweight or if you're normal range is to check your BMI. I'm going to leave a BMI calculator in the description below. It's really easy to use. You put your weight, your height, your gender in, it calculates it. It tells you if you're overweight, underweight, normal weight, whatever the status is. Now, if you are overweight and you're interested in losing weight, I do have quite a few videos on this topic, which have had millions of views, helping loads of people around the world to lose weight. So if you want more information on them, I will leave links to them up here and in the description below, looking at easy methods for you to lose weight. Okay, so I feel like we're starting to get somewhere now. We spoke about dietary advice, we spoke about snacking healthy, we spoke about BMI, we spoke about weight management and all these things that are gonna help reduce our sugar levels. But the next thing I wanna talk about is exercise. Look, we all know exercise makes us feel great, it makes us look better, it makes us stronger, but the other thing that it does is it helps keep those sugar levels down, which is what we wanted to do to reduce all those risk factors that we spoke about earlier. Now, for all adults, it's recommended that we do 150 minutes of moderate intensity exercise per week. And if you divide it up, it works out at about 21 minutes per day of moderate intensity exercise. Now, if you're wondering what are these moderate intensity exercises, there should be a box appearing here. You can have a look at it, see what fits you best and do them. However, please remember, moderate intensity exercise also includes walking, it includes hoovering, it includes tidying up at home, it includes walking up and down the steps. All of these things are included in that 150 minutes total weekly exercise that we need to do. Now, another thing that I want to mention is hydration. We need to be aiming for about 6 to 8 glasses of water in total per day. This is going to be really helpful for helping to keep those blood sugar levels down and keeping us healthy and hydrated. Please also remember that tea, your coffees, they also contribute to this. It's not just water. Any of your drinks that you're having like this, apart from alcohol, do contribute to this. But whilst we're on this note, it's important to remember that if you're having lots of fizzy drinks, if you're having milkshakes, if you're having sports drinks, boba tea, bubble tea, whatever kind of tea like that, that are all really high in sugar, it's not going to be helpful for us to keep those sugar levels low. We need to be aiming for more water on its own. If you want to give it some flavor, put some lemons in it. If you want to have some tea, try and have it without the sugar. But if you really need it to be sweet or your coffee to be sweet, you can try sweeteners instead, like we spoke earlier. But it's important that you're aware of these, because all of these are going to contribute to that increased sugar level and that increased HbA1c that we spoke about earlier. Another thing that I want to mention is alcoholic beverages. For example, a pint of cider can contain up to 5 teaspoons of sugar, and a lot of alcoholic drinks contain a lot of sugar. They contain a lot of calories, which again are not going to be helpful for losing weight, and also they're not going to be helpful for bringing down those sugar levels. So please bear this in mind. Remember that the recommended number of units per week for an adult is 14 units. You also need to have alcohol-free days. If you want more information on this and cutting down, I will leave more information in the description below. I also have a video on this topic, which I'll leave a link to up here as well. Moving on to the next topic that I want to discuss to reduce your blood sugar levels, sleep. It's super important that we are getting a minimum of 7 to 8 hours, preferably 8 hours of sleep per night, and good quality sleep. When we sleep, it gives our body time to do its maintenance work, okay? The handymen all come in, do the maintenance work, and it's gonna drop down those sugar levels as well. So we need to make sure we're getting enough sleep. You need a good sleep cycle. All of these things are gonna help. If you want more information on how to get better sleep, if you struggle with sleep at all, I have got a few videos on this topic as well, which again I'm gonna leave up here and in the description below. Meditation is also something that can be quite good for this as well, in reducing our sugar levels, because if you're always stressed and you're stressing out, it's going to increase our cortisol, which can increase our blood sugar levels, because we're going to eat stuff that's not really good for us, and all that stress is going to cause all of these problems as well. So try the meditation, 5 to 10 minutes a day. It's really easy to do. I'll leave some useful links about meditation as well in the description below if you're interested. Now, it's important to remember that sometimes your blood sugar levels might be too high, and it's important that you do speak to your healthcare professional. There are a few symptoms and signs that I want you to be aware of. I'm hopefully going to have a box pop up here, and there's going to be some information on here. Feel free to pause the video, give them a read. If any of these apply to you, please make an appointment to speak to your healthcare professional. That is the most important thing. So it looks like we're at the end of the video. I really hope you found this information helpful. You're now a bit of a diabetes pro. You now know about how to lower those blood sugar levels, and you know about the risk factors, and you know about testing and what ranges we're looking for good blood sugar levels or blood glucose levels, whatever you want to call it. So I really hope you found this information helpful. Please leave a comment below as well if you've got any of your own tips. I'd love to read it. I'm sure people watching this video would too. And as I always say, always remember that you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.